Welcome to Curlers Yum Terms. So it's biryani day and today we are going to make Lakhnavi Dum Biryani. So I'll tell you a very easy recipe. It's simple and easy to make. So let's get started. To marinate the chicken, I have washed chicken and it's completely dry. If you can see, my chicken is completely dry. This is about 2 kgs of chicken. I've added 1 big size onion caramelized. I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of coriander leaves. To this I'm going to add about 1/8 cup of mint leaves. While researching for Lakhnavi biryani, I saw some chefs using mint leaves and some not using mint leaves, so it's totally up to you. I prefer using mint leaf. I have about 1/2 cup of ginger, garlic and green chili paste. I have some whole garam masala, that is 1 big piece of cinnamon, 1 big bay leaf, about 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1 black cardamom, 3 green cardamom, 1 star anise and 1 mace. Now I'm going to add our seasonings and flavorings. I have salt as per taste, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. Now this biryani doesn't ask for red chili powder, but for just for a light color, I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, about 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. Now I've already added our whole spice masala, so I'm going to add these. Since I'm marinating this overnight, I'm not going to add any curd or dahi because it will leave water. So I'm not going to add them. Now I'm going to nicely mix it well. And I'm going to marinate it overnight. Chicken is ready with the marination. Now I'm going to put this in the fridge. It's going to marinate overnight. And we'll see with the rest of the process tomorrow. Our chicken has marinated well. Now to this handi, I'm going to add about 1/2 a cup of ghee. About 3 medium onions sliced. Now that our onions have softened well, I'm going to add our chicken. Now since I've added all the masalas while marinating the chicken, you do not need to add anything more. Sear the chicken well so that it locks in all the flavors and the moisture well. While my chicken cooks, I'll prepare the rest of the mixture. Here, in 1/2 a cup of milk, I had soaked badam and cashew, about 1 tablespoon each. I've soaked it for 1 hour, almost 1 hour now. Also into a small mixer grinder, I have about 5/4 of cardamom and about 1 whole mace or jawitri. And also I have my rose essence, my kevda essence. I'll be adding about 2 tablespoons of cream and also about 1 cup of homemade dahi. Since the quantity is very less, that's the reason I have had added our cashew, badam and milk to our cardamom and jawitri. If you do not want that and you prefer grinding it separately, it's totally up to you. Now that our chicken is cooking in its own juice and I've also prepared our cream mixture, it is time to prepare our rice now. We usually cook the rice about 70 to 80%. If you are in doubt, just cook the rice to about 70%. Keep it a little raw or else it's going to cook really well and it's going to mash up and become more of a pulao consistency. You do not want that. Now I've kept about 2 liters of water to boil. Let it boil vigorously. Now to this I'm going to add about 3 to 4 heaped teaspoon of salt. Now you want the water to literally taste like sea water, because you're going to ultimately drain the water, so you do not want to lightly season it, you want to heavily season it. And also I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of ghee. To this I'm not going to add any whole masala, because I've already added enough to our chicken, so I'm not going to add anything anymore. Let this boil vigorously. I have washed my rice and kept it for soaking for about 1.5 hours now. I'm going to drain it. I usually have seen chefs using arwa rice. I couldn't get hold of arwa rice, that's the reason I'm using regular basmati. Please do not use long grain basmati, because the flavor is more, it really smells good. So that will overpower the chicken flavor or the mutton flavor. So do not use the extra long or the long basmati rice. Now that our water is vigorously boiling, I'm going to add our soaked rice. Now that our rice is 70% cooked, I'm going to drain it. Now finally our chicken and the mixture is well combined, so now it's our dum time. I'm going to dum my chicken and rice together for at least 2 hours. I'm going to top this with little coriander and mint. Now time for my rice. Flatten it well. I'm going to add about 1 tablespoon of ghee. I've soaked my saffron and milk, hot milk. So I'm going to add that. This is about 1/4 cup. I'm also going to add little rose essence. Also some kevda essence. Finally, some chopped mint and coriander leaves. I'm going to seal it with atta. Now that I've lined my handi with atta, I'm going to close it tightly. I'm going to seal it well. Now I'm going to dum this process. I'm going to keep a tawa. On top of the tawa, I'm going to keep my handi and dum it at least for 2 hours. And that's when you are ready with your biryani. So I'm going to dum it for 2 hours. Finally, the wait is over. I'm going to open my dum. See, it's nice and done. So I'm going to open it. Oh wow. I'm going to transfer this to a nice biryani plate. I'm going to garnish with some coriander and mint, some ginger julienne, some sliced green chilies, and serve it with a cucumber raita. Finally, my Lucknowi biryani is ready. It's to be eaten with hands. With some cucumber raita. You can make any raita, onion, bundi, it's up to you, but do try this at home. It's very tasty, the aroma is very good, it's filled my house and people cannot wait. So before we sign out, do like, share and do comment. Let me know what you guys think. Don't forget to subscribe. Wait for more videos, wait for more recipes. Bye-bye.